following prayer. It's good to see all of you on this wonderful day. Remember this day in February, right? Welcome to friends joining us online. I'm Kathleen Aitken. Jeff and I have returned from Northern Ontario, where we lived for 15 years. I miss Lake Superior. But it's good to be back among maple trees and farmland. We're grateful for the warm welcome we received at Trinity Durham, our new spiritual home. We're among friends. A vacation Bible camp for children, kindergarten to grade 6, will be held from August 14th to 18th, from 9 till noon, at Knox United Church. Please see Robin for more information. And are there any other announcements? Okay. We're at the end of July. Have there been any birthdays or anniversaries or other important events that we should know about? We'd love to celebrate with you. No one's going to own up. If you have a birthday, happy birthday. And many, many more. Any anniversaries? Okay, we have a celebration anniversary here. I understand it's how many years?
41.
Oh, 41. They figured out how to keep it together. Please join us for coffee downstairs after the service. We'll begin with our land acknowledgement. We acknowledge with respect that Bruce County and Grey County are situated on the traditional and treaty territory of the Anishinaabeg. The people of the Three Fires, known as Ojibwe, Odawa, and Potawatomi Nations, and homeland of the Chippewas of Saugeen, the Chippewas of Neashinaabeg, and the Métis. This territory is covered by the Upper Canada Treaties. May we all, as treaty people, live with respect on this land and live in peace and friendship with all its diverse peoples. Our opening hymn is 37. We will sing in the morning.
Thank you.
To whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Our service continues on page 45 of the Book of Alternative Services, the Green Book. Dear friends in Christ, as we prepare to worship Almighty God, let us with penitent and obedient hearts confess our sins, that we may obtain forgiveness by his infinite goodness and mercy. Together.
Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy upon us, pardon and deliver us from all our sins, confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and keep us in eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, open our lips,
and our mouth shall proclaim your praise.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
Alleluia. The Spirit of the Lord renews the face of the earth. O come, let us worship. We'll say together the 90 on page 49.
Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for the joy of the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and raise a loud shout to him with songs. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are all caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have molded the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee, and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Oh, that today you would hearken to his voice.
Please be seated for the reading of the scripture.
Our first reading is a reading from the book of Genesis. Laban said to Jacob, "Because you are my kinsman, should you therefore serve me for nothing? Tell me, what shall your wages be?" Now Laban had two daughters. The name of the elder was Leah, and the name of the younger was Rachel. Leah's eyes were lovely, and Rachel was graceful and beautiful. Jacob loved Rachel, so he said, "I will serve you 7 years for your younger daughter, Rachel." Laban said, "It is better that I give her to you than I should give her to any other man. Stay with me." So Jacob served 7 years for Rachel, and they seemed to him but a few days because of the love he had for her. Then Jacob said to Laban, "Give me my wife that I may go into her, for my time is completed." So Laban gathered together all the people of the place and made a feast. But in the evening he took his daughter Leah and brought her to Jacob, and he went into her. Laban gave his maid Zilpah to his daughter Leah to be her maid. When morning came, it was Leah, and Jacob said to Laban, "What is this you have done to me? Did I not serve you with you for Rachel? Why then have you deceived me?" Laban said, not done in our country. Giving the younger before the firstborn. Complete the week of this one, and we will give you the other, also in return for serving me another 7 years. Jacob did so and completed her week. Then Laban gave him his daughter Rachel as a wife. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our psalm this morning is Psalm number 105, verses 1 to 11, 45 to C, found on page 845. And we will read responsively after the asterisk. Give thanks to the Lord and call upon his name.
Make known his deeds among the peoples.
Sing to him, sing praises to him.
And speak of all his marvelous works.
Glory in his holy name.
Let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice.
Search for the Lord and his strength.
Continually seek his face.
Remember the marvels he has done.
His wonders and judgments of us.
O offspring of Abraham, his servant.
O children of Jacob, his chosen.
He is the Lord our God.
His judgments prevail in all the world.
He has always been mindful of his covenant.
The promise he made for a thousand generations.
The covenant he made with Abraham.
The oath that he swore to Isaac.
Which he established as a statute for Jacob.
An everlasting covenant for Israel.
Saying, to you will I give the land of Canaan.
To be your allotted inheritance.
That night they might keep his statutes. Hallelujah. And at the bottom of page 848, together. God of our salvation, through the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ, you have fulfilled your promise to our ancestors in the faith to redeem the world from slavery and to lead us into the promised land. Grant us living water from the rock and bread from heaven, that we may survive our desert pilgrimage and praise you forever through Jesus Christ, our Redeemer. A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought, but that very Spirit intercedes with sighs too deep for words. And God, who searches the heart, knows what is the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. We know that all things work together for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose. For those whom he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, in order that he might be the firstborn within a large family. And those whom he predestined, he also called. And those whom he called, he also justified. And those whom he justified, he also glorified. What then are we to say about these things? If God is for us, who is against us? He who did not withhold his own Son, but gave him up for all of us, will he not with him also give us everything else? Who will bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, yes, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our gradual hymn is number 60, I Come With Joy.
Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
He put before them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed that someone took and sowed in his field. It is the smallest of all the seeds, but when it is grown, it is the greatest of shrubs and becomes a tree, so that the birds of the air come and make nests in its branches. He told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed in with 3 measures of flour until all of it was leavened. The kingdom of heaven is like treasure hidden in a field, which someone found and hid. Then in his joy, he goes and sells all he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant in search of fine pearls. On finding one pearl of great value, he went and sold all he had and bought it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net that was thrown into the sea and caught fish of every kind. When it was full, they drew it ashore, sat down, and put the good into baskets, but threw out the bad. So it will be at the end of the age. The angels will come out and separate the evil from the righteous and throw them into a furnace of fire, where they'll be weeping and gnashing of teeth. The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
May the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be acceptable to you, O God, my strength and my Redeemer.
Amen.
Please be seated. I would like to have been there learning from Jesus among his disciples, asking him questions. We understand that in private with his disciples, Jesus gave more explanation of his parables, things they would need to know in order to carry on his ministry. But God has given us lives in the 20th and 21st centuries. We consider ourselves more modern. Certainly science has explained a lot of things, but human nature has not changed very much. Our readings this month have described faith in terms of seeds that germinate and flourish if planted in good soil and provided with sun and moisture. Today, on the ninth Sunday after Pentecost, the readings continue the series of parables. This time, Jesus is talking about the kingdom of heaven. He is preparing his disciples for his leaving them. In the Gospel of John, he said, "I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also." In Matthew, Jesus describes the kingdom of heaven. It is like a treasure worth giving up everything else for. The kingdom of heaven will start small, like a mustard seed, and grow to become a refuge and place of joy for those who have followed him. The seeds we grow to build up Christ's church on earth will act like leaven flour, growing in the place that Jesus is preparing for all who are faithful. The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure greater than anything we might value. Our small treasures just don't compare. At the end of the age, it will be decided who has merited a place in the kingdom. We repeat the teachings of Jesus in the Lord's Prayer and the creeds. We pray to our Father in heaven and say, "Thy kingdom come." And we ask for forgiveness. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. In our creeds, we affirm our faith that Jesus will come again to judge the living and the dead. As Heather said last week, it is not for us to judge who will be accepted into the kingdom of heaven. We might have a role to play, though, by helping others to come to faith in Christ.
next month or the next year, but is not yet the end of the age. Jesus might have known that we would still be looking for the kingdom of heaven, the gospel would be taken to the Gentiles, Rome would fall, faithful Christians would save the precious scriptures written after Jesus' death and resurrection. The Bible would be compiled. Thomas Cranmer would lead the drafting of the first English Book of Common Prayer. English clergy would be educated. A copy of the Bible in the language of the people would finally be placed in each church, helping parishioners to become literate. God has been with our church. We have grown in faith and understanding, even asking for forgiveness for past mistakes. The kingdom of heaven might be closer now than in biblical terms, according to our understanding of time. In every generation, we interpret Jesus' words according to our understanding, and with God's help, we follow. We might come closest to understanding the treasure that is the kingdom of heaven when someone we love dies. The last time I saw my cousin Nori, we reminisced about our much younger days. I kind of knew my cousins were supposed to look after me, but they didn't make me feel any different because I was the youngest Patterson kid, walking home from school, preferring to follow the railway track because it was a little shorter than taking the road. A question is left. Could you really tell if there was a steam engine train coming if you put your ear down to the rail or felt it, upright vibration? A few weeks ago, Nori died at 91. Great-grandchildren were among the pallbearers. Nori was always caring, always spreading happiness. He was making jokes on his deathbed. He built onto his house so family members would always have a place to come and stay if they needed to. He never argued, even deferred to others. He was quoted as saying many times to his wife, "You might be right, dear." Obviously, he was a wise man, too. Led by one of Nori's nephews, we followed the Anglican funeral service in sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life. Through the Lord Jesus Christ, we ask God to receive Nori into the arms of his mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. All of us certain that Nori was worthy of the treasure of the kingdom of heaven. And he was an example to follow. We are comforted by the hope of resurrection and eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. My cousin John said, "We were 8 children, now we are down to 3. Many of us wonder sometimes why we are still alive. Henry Nouwen, whose writing gives me inspiration and helps my understanding, advises that if we are lonely because our loved ones have gone, we need to turn our loneliness into a gift for others and for the world. We are still alive, he says, because God is not finished with us. We have a mission in the world. Matthew 6 quotes Jesus, Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, but store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust consumes, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. We are asked to consider what is important. I thought about my own earthly treasures. After our move, I am still trying to sort so we can throw out things we don't need. Most of what we have would not be wanted by the next generation, but they give us the basics for living. We don't need much, but the temptation to acquire is still there. Among my treasures are piles of books. Some are textbooks, others are books that entertain or increase my understanding of people and life in different places. Then there are the rocks, picked up on walks along various beaches, because I cannot bring home the running water and the sound and the spray of the rolling waves. There are just a few inexpensive reproductions of art in our home, because we love color in nature, in patterns, in fabric. But the best things are connections with friends and loved ones, smiles and conversations, being together. It is such a gift being human and a child of God. We have heavenly treasures on earth, Christ with us, providing forgiveness, joy, and comfort. As I grow older, some of my memories have become treasures. One of the best is the memory of being carried by my dad. It was a summer day. Nothing interesting was going on in the house, so I went looking for my dad at the barn. He wasn't in the horse stable, just inside the door. The horses were out, so were the milk cows. The floors were clean, but they must have been a bit wet in the cow stable. I didn't know that Dad wasn't quite finished cleaning the stables. I went outside and walked down the side of the barn calling, "Daddy!" The contents of Dad's shovel found me. I was covered in cow manure. It's the trip to the house that I remember best, being carried in Dad's arms as he delivered me to my mother for cleaning and a bran muffin to take the taste out of my mouth. This story reminds me now of baptism, the washing away of sin, becoming new and clean, and the loving arms of Jesus. I have all these memory treasures that point to the love of God. Can we be clear about how we are to store up treasures in heaven? In the context of our time, consumer society has led to high prices and workaholism. Unsustainable when we consider the economic and environmental difficulties projected for our children. Meanwhile, many people in other parts of the world try to live without necessities. What are the treasures that Jesus wants us to store up in heaven? Maybe we should ask what we have done with the talents that God gave us. Not just how we've used those talents to build a career, unless what we gained we have used to the glory of God. will we be able to show that we have loved God and shown love for our neighbor in what we have done? How much have we shared the love and joy we have been given? How much have we helped those who needed laughter and peace? Have we truly been servants of God and each other? We know the stories of disciples who left everything to follow Christ. Our mission, then, is to continue their contribution to the kingdom of heaven. We are called to pay attention, to be a different force in our world, contributing to the kingdom of heaven by what we are and what we do, showing the light of Christ, each in our own way. I said at the beginning that I would like to have been there, learning from Jesus among his disciples. Speaking of Mary, the sister of Martha and Lazarus, now and says, we are called to continue to be at the feet of Jesus. That's where my identity is rooted. That's who I am. Let us pray. Be with us, Lord, in our minds and our hearts as we strive to be worthy of your treasures. Amen.
Is 299. In the name of Christ, we gather.
Thank you.
look forward to the glory you have promised. This we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Let us affirm our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Please sit or kneel as you're most comfortable for the prayers of the people.
The litany is number 2, found on page 112 of the Book of Alternative Services. Let us pray with confidence to the Lord, saying, Lord, hear our prayer. O Lord, guard and direct your church in the way of unity, service, and praise.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Give to all nations an awareness of the unity of the human family.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Cleanse our hearts of prejudice and selfishness, and inspire us to hunger and thirst for what is right.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Teach us to use your creation for your greater praise, that all may share the good things you provide.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Strengthen all who give their energy or skill for the healing of those who are sick in body or in mind.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Set free all who are bound by fear and despair.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Grant a peaceful end and eternal rest to all who are dying, and your comfort to those who mourn.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, the protector of all who trust in you, without whom nothing is strong, nothing is holy, increase and multiply upon us your mercy, that with you as our ruler and guide, we may so pass through the things temporal that we lose not the things eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The blessing is in the bulletin. Let us say it together.
May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Our recessional hymn is 35, O God, our sons and daughters. us go with God into a new week. Bless the Lord. Thanks be to God.